Hi everyone, it's time to update my Config Manager lab to the latest update, which is 2107. So I thought I'd just share that with you and go through it now. So if we head over to our Config Manager server and then jump into the administration, we'll take a look at what version I've got installed right now in the updates and servicing node. And as you can see, I've got 2103, which is the baseline version. So if you were to install your Config Manager server for the first time or fresh install, then you would have to install a baseline version. And that's what 2103 is. It isn't the first time I've installed Config Manager. I have upgraded it since, but I'm currently at the baseline version, so that's good. So from here, you can see we've got two options. We've got the hotfix rollup, which I could install, and we've got the 2107. They're both ready to install. Now, you don't need to install the hotfix before you do the latest version. All of that will be included in the cumulative update, so that's all good. We're ready to go with this update. So it's a case of just taking a look at what we've got. It says it's ready to install, which means it's already downloaded. So I let it go through that process of downloading the update before I started this video, because that would be incredibly boring for you to watch. But now we've got the choice. When we right click, we can either install it or run a prerequisite check. Now, with the prereq check in this case, I would encourage you to run the prerequisite check separate from the update pack, because there will probably be an issue that you come up with. It'll be something you can ignore, but it might be something you want to take a look at. So we'll do that first. Obviously, it will run the prereq check when you click install update pack, but let's just do it as a separate prereq check first, so you've got some time to consider what the options are if you're not quite ready to finish that update. And then you'll have a prerequisite check status on your dashboard to say, you know, the prereq check has either passed or failed or passed with warnings. And then you won't have a failed update in your console if you decide to abort it just then. So let's choose run prerequisite check, and it'll change this status here to check and prereqs. This will be the status for quite a long time. It's not going to be a very quick prerequisite check. And if you go to show status at the bottom right here, we can click on that's not going to help. That's the 2103. We can click on that for 2107 here, and just see what it's doing and going through, and then we can follow it when it has finished loading. So we'll give this a few minutes to load and do its prerequisite check, and then we'll come back to this dashboard in a few minutes and see how it's gone. So it's been 2 or 3 minutes now, and you can see it's changed the status in the monitoring tab anyway to replicating content. So we'll give this a few more minutes. We'll give it as long as it takes, to be honest, to get to the next stage, and I'll update you as it moves along. Okay, so it's been about an hour now, and I haven't refreshed it since. So we'll give this just a refresh here to see if it changes the status. It has changed, that's good. So it says prerequisite check passed with warning. So that's kind of what I expected, given what I've seen of the update so far. But as you can see here, we've got the prerequisite check here, and that will say completed with warning, which is good. And so you can see there's a couple of warnings. So for me, we've got the checkif.net version is 4.8. That's a new thing with 2107. That's just become a requirement. And then 4.6.2, that's true for this. You keep your server up to date and stuff, so that'll just fix itself. So we're able to skip this one. This is just a warning, so we can just skip past this one. And for me, I've got the functional level check. Verify that the domain functional level is 2003 or later. It definitely is later than 2003. I think it might be 2016. So I'm not sure why that one has failed. But I'm personally going to skip past that one, because I know that the domain functional level is higher than 2003, so that's great. And yeah, so that's all I need to do. I'm not going to update 4.8, because I'm going to have to skip the prerequisite warnings anyway in order to get past this domain functional level check. Okay, so we'll close this, and then the next step is to right click and move back into the administration tab, updates and servicing, and see what we've got here. It says prerequisite check passed, which is good. So we'll right click and choose install update pack. and we'll go through this wizard. Now you can see in this wizard screen, we've got the versions that it tells us what will be included in this version. So it's going to have some site server updates, some console updates, client updates, fixes for known issues that you can find on the Microsoft website, and also some new features. So that's great, I'm going to go ahead, but I want to tick this button here, which will ignore the prerequisite warnings, because we've already been through them, and I'm happy for it to sail straight through them, because I just wanted to install, even though I don't have .NET 4.8 installed. So I'm going to click that and choose Next. And then I do want to add these features. So I want to add in the CMG with VM skill set, because that's the next video I'm going to be doing. But I'm not going to add in BitLocker management today, because that's a video I'm going to do in the future. I don't want to wreck my MVAM installation that I've currently got already. So we're going to choose Next. And I'm going to upgrade without validating. But this client updates piece is all about how you can validate that the client that you're upgrading your computers to, the CM client, doesn't break stuff. So typically in a larger organization, you would have a small collection, which is a set of computers that you upgrade first. And just like you do with Windows updates and Office updates, you check that it doesn't break anything. So that's what this client update settings is all about. I don't have a pilot collection because I've only got a very small lab environment. So that's not relevant for me, but please do consider updating with a validation pre-production collection. Next, the license terms. Obviously, it's really important that we read and agree to these, and then choose Next. And that's it. That's all you need to do to get that ready to install. When I choose Next, it will go away and do the installation. So let's start that process, because I'm going to need to take an hour or so, or a slightly longer break while it does that installation. So I'll cut the video and come back to you really shortly. In the meantime, let's just use Next and see that start the progress. And there we go. You can see it says the things it's going to be doing is ignore the prerequisite check. It's going to turn on the new feature about the VM skill set for Cloud Management Gateway, and I love this, I love the way it phrases this, it's going to test the new version of the client in production, which is a fantastic way of saying we don't care about the client upgrade. So if we choose Close, you can see it says checking prerequisites. It still needs to do that prereq check, because things might have changed since you last ran the prereq check, so that's important for it to continue doing that. And if we click on Show Status there, it will take us over to the to this monitoring tab here, where we can see what's going on. I will take a look at this and monitor it for us, and then in probably about half an hour to an hour, I'll come back to it and show you what's going on. Okay, so as you can probably tell by the lighting and in a few seconds, the clock that I'm about to show you, the time has gone by a significant time, probably about 6 hours since I started this video. But that means that the upgrade has completed. So what we can do now is jump back to the screen, take a look at what it says, and go from there. So as you can see, the state is installed. And it says a new version of the console is available. This one here, I'm not going to read the number because you can read. And it says we're working in the old console, and that might corrupt data. So we can either just close the current console and reloading it will automatically install the new one, or we can click on the handy button which says install the new console version, which I'm going to do. I'll choose yes to elevate to admin, and it will download the files. I believe it's downloading the files from the site server, not from the internet. Probably doesn't matter, but I believe it's doing that. Okay, so that's just about finishing up. That actually took a lot longer than usual, a lot longer than I was expecting. It's still whirring away in the background there, and it's now just about coming back to life. It took about 8 minutes, I think, from remembering what the clock said when we started, which, very odd, yeah. Okay. So, let's see how this goes. Okay, so, you know, nothing special when you start, this is a very simple video of the upgrade process. Let's just check that everything's gone well and we've got the right versions installed. So if you see, we've got 2107, and we'll just quickly go through the process that it went through to get to the stage it's at now. Click on Show Status and should hopefully see what happened. So it did some downloading and some replication, and then the prereq check again. We had a couple of warnings, just these two here, .NET framework not being 4.8 and the functional level check. I must check that out at some point, why I'm not being able to determine the functional level. Then the installation itself, it did this, and if you're interested in the process it goes through for your own testing, change requests, that kind of thing, these are the steps, so you can take a look. And then the post-installation are these sort of the stuff it does just to get back on track and reinstall all the data, the services that it needs to do. And right at the end there, it turned on some features for me, which I would assume would be the Cloud Management Gateway skill set that I'm hoping to use. So yeah, that's that. Heading back over to admin and then features, just check the features we've got. So the Cloud Management Gateway with Azure VM skill set is turned on. That's brilliant. And that's the, one of the things I'm hoping to be demonstrating in one of the next videos that I get a chance to do. So thanks for watching. Please hit the like button and I'll see you soon.